There is one thing that has been happening to me repeatedly since I started posting content about the development of my game Spaceman Memories. And this was one thing that many people were telling me over and over and over again. And I am very open about my creative process, I am very transparent about my game influences, and I am not trying to reinvent the wheel. Nevertheless, this was still hammering my head. So what was it? Your game looks way too much like Pokemon. You know what? I know my game looks somewhat like Pokemon. I openly said it in my first devlog that the main influence visually for this game are the Game Boy Advance games I played through an emulator at the beginning of the 2000s in Windows. So why is this a problem? This is not a Pokemon clone, this is more like a story driven game and less about collecting creatures or grinding to level up. So this would be something more like Earthbound meets Pokemon. So I went back to the drawing board to redesign the aspect of the game that most resembled a Pokemon game. So which was that? The battle screen. I had lots of fun building this part of the game. This was a good UI and UX design challenge, as it was not related specifically to new gameplay mechanics or programming, as the underlying code is the same one I was using before. As a matter of fact, if you wanna see how I build this code on a step-by-step process, you can go and see the past devlogs, as they are a full hands-on tutorial. Also, remember that you can support this channel by going into Redbubble to get the official NerdyPunk swag, and also you can join the Patreon to access some exclusive perks, okay? So let's get into it. The first thing I thought I should swap about the battle screen UI was the over-the-shoulder perspective that Pokemon games use. I didn't go for that classic Final Fantasy style, the over-the-top side camera, which would be the most obvious idea for a turn-based RPG. I ended up pondering, decided that the least obvious solution for a turn-based RPG is a full side camera game style, something between a platformer and a fighting game. This is the way I ended up building it. First, I decided that I should start designing the astronaut. I started with some side poses to find something that would work. The astronaut will always be carrying a weapon when in battle mode, so it was essential to create him in that way from the beginning. After a few iterations on body size, proportion, and head shape, I was able to come up with something that resembled the astronaut I'm using in my game art. Next thing was working on the background of the battle screen so that this new perspective would work with the new astronaut. I needed something that would work for now as a placeholder for visual clarity. I went to my HIO library to look for a pack of assets that were for a platformer, since that side perspective is what I needed for this new version of the battle screen. Fortunately, I found something that worked for me. This pack called Huge Pixel Art Asset Pack created by Sam, so thanks Sam. I took some blocks from this style set and modified them to fit the color palette of my game. I used them for the battle screen floor, and for the background I ended up using a modified version of the background I used previously. With this all done, I started thinking about the design of the enemies. As I mentioned in another video, the story of my game is related to Japanese culture. Specifically, I will be basing a lot of the story on Japanese folktales. My main reference will be spirits better known as yokai, which can be good or bad. As the first yokai enemy, I decided on the Yamauba, or also known as the Yamamba, which is an evil entity with an interesting story. The Yamauba are mountain witches that can present themselves as harmless entities. They can be old ladies who offer help, or they can also present themselves as a beautiful, attractive young woman who also deceives you with her charms. Behind this facade, they are actually cannibalistic evil witches who prey on naive travelers. Pretty cool, right? I studied traditional Japanese art references to find a form and proportion that work for me. For this enemy, I am using a resolution of 64x72 pixels. This allows me to have a model that is not so simplistic, but it doesn't become too complex either to match the rest of the game. I brought it to my battle screen, and after that I could start thinking about all the new mechanics of the turn-based battle system. I have moved some things around and discarded others. Let's see how I put it together. First, I thought about the position of the HUDs of the player and the enemy. I will be using a more basic and simple health bar, where the only thing that is displayed is the health of the entity. I got rid of the health point and the level numbers. I may end up adding this information back at another time, but for now, for the type of game I have in mind, it is not necessary. Then, I had to find a way to solve the problem of available space for the player buttons and the information I wanted to display on the screen. I have decided to simplify everything, and I will only have two buttons at the start of the battle, one to fight and enter the battle, and one to run away from it. This simplifies everything and makes the gameplay more fluid for the type of game I have in mind. After that, I have added this box at the bottom of the player, and inside I have decided to set the name of the selected attack along with a bar that shows the power available for that attack. I also decided to place the buttons for the available attacks on top of the player's health bar. I have added an image to each attack to now have a reference both as a text at the bottom and a cool button at the top. I find that this makes this whole system really look more fun, and it also has a bit of an identity on its own. Getting all this to work has not been a complicated process, as it was more about replacing sprites and changing positions within Unity. I didn't have to modify the code except for adding a line to the dialog box script. This line of code is to hide the dialog box in certain moments of the battle, unlike the previous system in which the dialog box was always on the screen. After all this process, I just had to refine a few details to get my new battle screen up and running. All of this works flawlessly because this is a very modular system. The underlying code of this turn-based battle system gives me lots of flexibility and customization. That's where the power of it lies in. By connecting all these dots, all of the systems started working flawlessly. As I said before, building this inside Unity was an easy process because this is a very modular system and the underlying code is the same. What took me more time was delving into Aseprite to decide where to put these new pieces and make all of the UI work, so this was a fun process. In the next videos, I'm gonna delve deeper into the Japanese culture within my game, and also I'm gonna talk about how I am redesigning the whole map to make it work with the story. As always, thanks for watching, see you the next time.